One of the questions I get most often is about happiness. What is happiness? Why does happiness matter? And what are practical tips to maximize happiness? So I'm going to talk about those three topics. What is happiness? As far back as we can in history to read what philosophers wrote about happiness, one of the specific passages I found most interesting is Aristotle talks about what does it mean to be a good human, right? Like what makes a good knife? A good knife is one that is good at the thing that the knife is designed to do. So he says a good knife is something that is good at cutting. I think that every person has their own thing that they're good at and that brings them happiness. It's a non-ending conversation on what is the true meaning of happiness and should you be optimizing for happiness or should you be optimizing for hedonism or should you be optimizing for like success at all costs? And sometimes I see people that just care about long-term success or gain and they're willing to sacrifice everything in the short term to have that. And I think that's a wrong strategy. I think you can have your cake and eat it too. For example, let's think about startups. The analogy I always use, it's like a Jeep that's going through the savannah. And the number one thing that is most important is you don't stop driving. If you stop driving, that's it, you're out. You're not gonna make it to the finish line. And you gotta therefore make sure that there's enough air in your wheels. For me, I'm very lucky that, you know, no matter what happens in the startup, there's always air in my wheels. And the reason there's air in my wheels is because there's other pillars to my happiness. My family, sports, music, reading. And so there's always something that's still bolstering me up. If you're putting all your eggs in one basket, which is, you know, the well-being of your career, things won't work out well. What are the most authentic moments of happiness that are lasting as opposed to something that's, you know, on the hedonic treadmill? I think the first one is, you know, true moments of love, whether it be with your family or your friends. Same thing for learning. Like sometimes I have these epiphanies about the world. You know, I read a passage from On Wealth from Emerson or The Way of Kings by Brandon Sanderson, and my worldview just changed and I'm so satisfied that it did because I know that I'm from this point on gonna make better decisions. When I see other people who I love doing well, there's a great word in Tibetan called mudita, which is the joy that you get from the success of others. Practice mudita. If you get really good at it, that's it. You just multiply the amount of happiness you're going to experience on a regular basis. Lastly, it's, you know, expressing gratitude. Whether it be I'm walking around and I lie on a patch of grass and I look at the stars and I think about the universe and how grateful I am to be here and to have the life that I have and to know the people that I know. And even if I had no physical possessions and even no connections, I'm just lucky to be breathing. Another really important thing to consider is looking happy versus being happy. A lot of times, people's predisposition to feeling depressed is partly triggered by feeling jealous of people that they see on the internet. The thing there is you have to make sure that if you feel jealous of a person, you want to switch lives with them, you got to switch your entire lives with them. As in, you have to go fully in their shoes, not just one part of it. So that means, you know, their family, their upbringing, their situation, their mental health, and you don't know what you're buying with that. So what are practical things to optimize for happiness? Well, it depends on who you are. Like Aristotle said, you know, you want to define what makes a good human, but what makes a good you. And so for me, the way I think about it is my happiness in life can be measured by the number of conversations that I finish with I love you, because I think that the biggest impact for my happiness is the quality of my interpersonal relationships. But that's a me thing, you know, many of you guys might resonate with that, but maybe for you guys, you know, the end all be all is playing football and all you want to do is, you know, go outside and throw a ball around. Maybe it's playing chess. Find those pillar habits that you can do on a regular basis, whether it be, you know, calling your siblings or your family or your friends, whatever it might be, to optimize for your happiness. One really powerful tool is called the Wheel of Life. You can go and find the website for it on the internet, and it has 10 different categories in it. And you can fill it from 1 to 10, what your ranking is in each one of those categories. And I find this to be a really useful pulse check on your levels of happiness. And it's like debugging a piece of software. If there's a bug in the software, you go figure out where the bug is and you fix it. But most people don't debug their own brain or their emotional well-being and they don't fix it. So the most recent one, my life on the outside was perfect. And I was not feeling like I was making progress. But what I did is I built a Notion document called Happiness Tracker. And every day, 3 times a day, I would rate my happiness on a scale of 1 to 10. And then I would write next to the score, what was the thing that impacted my happiness? Was it the fact that I ate a good meal? Was it the fact that I had great conversations with friends? Was it the fact that I went on like a nice walk with my girlfriend? Was it the fact that I had a really negative interaction with a customer support rep? Was it the fact that I was trying to move a KPI on Speedify and I was not succeeding? The second I started tracking things, I started realizing what were the things in my life that were in a funk and was able to start changing them. And then when I was young, I had a really tough time making friends. I don't know why. And you know, there was this like one very traumatic moment where like we're in the middle of class. And again, I'm the smallest kid. And this kid turns around and slaps me in the face and chokes me in the middle of class. Like I was too small. I couldn't do anything about it. And like this was a pretty common occurrence for me to be bullied. But the answer is, you know, life changes. A year is a blimp and it can feel very big right now, but it's not actually that big. You want to make sure that the air is always in the wheels of the Jeep, and you want to make sure you figure out what your pillars are. I'm really excited that you're joining me in this journey, both in building Speechify, but also in thinking and philosophizing and figure out how to build the best life for each one of us. One thing I challenge you to do is if you feel grateful to someone in your life with whom you experienced a true, genuine feeling of happiness, text them about it. Write to them about the thing that you're grateful for that they added to your life, whether it be a dinner that you had together, something that they told you, you know, something that they gave you or did with you, an adventure, whatever it might be. Even better is if you write to them an adventure that you want to do together with them or something you appreciate about them. And then if it's a good story that you're willing to share, include it in the comments below. And if you're reading those comments, practice mudita. I hope you keep up with the journey with us. So, you know, it would make me very happy if you subscribe, but it would make me even more happy if you downloaded Speechify. You can read more of my Medium articles here. You can follow me on Instagram and LinkedIn here. Thank you for watching. Happy listening.